So college volleyball popped off this year. It's 2023 and literally millions of people were watching, but so many records were broken this season, from 1.7 million viewers on the national championship game to 90,000 plus fans in a football stadium watching an outdoor Nebraska game to setting the indoor record for a women's sporting event. Like, it's literally insane the amount of records and recognition that college volleyball has gotten in the last, I'd say, since I've been in college. It's just been crazy watching.
Championship point. Let's be very clear. Nebraska, for the entirety of the season, has been the best team in college volleyball. To see what Texas has done to the number one overall seed is nothing short of dominant.
For the championship. Just like last year, back to back on an ace for Texas!
So, my college scene was a little different, or not the typical, you verbally commit your sophomore year of high school, maybe freshman, and then you sign like your junior year or senior year of high school.
So, Julia wasn't even supposed to be here. She was supposed to be somewhere else.
For me, I was at another university, or committed, verbally committed to another university. Coaching changes happened, stuff happened, and on the Monday night before Wednesday signing day, I decided to decommit. I just felt like it wasn't the great fit, nothing against anyone personally, just with everything that went on, I decided to remove myself from that situation. And so that happens my senior, fall of my senior year, and I was like, crap, I need to find somewhere to go if this is truly what I want. And by the grace of God, he found me a place in Troy, Alabama. First, being in high school in St. Louis, Missouri, I was like, where's Troy, Alabama? I know of Troy, Missouri. But I found out that that was exactly where I was supposed to be. And this video is showing just a few things that I've learned from college volleyball and getting to share a couple of the stories of the people I met and the experiences that I went through. For the top five things that I learned, number one was the two L's that I took away. And you can see this on an Instagram post I made about a month ago. But there's two L's that I took away from playing college volleyball for 5 years. That is love and learning. And first is love, that it always wins. There's nothing that is more powerful than love and being around your teammates, your coaches, your support crew there at college, that there's nothing else can beat that. And then learning is that there's always a spot to learn. Like, you never stop unless you put yourself, if you close yourself off from learning. So continuing to put yourself in new experiences. For me, that was going to leadership forums, trying new things with friends.
Freshies fun fact day one.
There are 90 steps to the top of the hill.
Jessica. The two lanes are switched. The one goes this way and the one goes that way at Newman.
If you see a raccoon outside in the middle of the day, it's sick.
What was mine? I'm forgetting now.
A jellyfish.
Oh, you can pet certain types of jellyfish.
Then second is network and communication. If you're anywhere around a volleyball court, like, one of the top rules is communicate. And learning that through college, different people take on different roles and different people support you in different ways, and being able to talk to your AD or talk to your strength coach or talk to a teacher, and realizing that this life isn't meant to be lived alone. So networking and making bonds that are worth, like, connecting is huge. So the third thing I learned is less is more. And that might be ironic with this video of me going on about all my experiences and lessons, but through college I learned that you can just feel what you're going through and you don't have to overthink about it. Now, this took me a long time to learn. It probably took me all the way to the end of my last season at college. But learning to feel what you gotta feel, voice what you have to say, and then move on from it. There's no reason to dwell in the past. You can look back and learn from it, but there's no reason to live there. If you're living too far in the past, then you never can truly listen to the people around you. And that's a major thing that we learned, is you're always like your own main character, but if you learn to treat others as a main character, and everyone does that, it's a game changer. My grandma's calling me. Let's answer her. Hi, Grandma.
Hi, sweetie. How are you?
Good. I'm making a vlog right now. Is this important?
Okay. All right. Thanks.
I love you.
Bye-bye. Love you too. Bye.
Bye. Okay. What I was saying was, the fourth thing that I took away was, you have an option of how you can react towards things. And for me, getting frustrated because something's not working out or not understanding what's going on versus just allowing yourself to be there and allowing it to take its course, it opened many doors for me, because when I wasn't allowing experience to happen, then I couldn't learn from it, I couldn't move on from it, I couldn't do the next thing I needed to do, because I was so focused or holding on so tight because I cared so much that I couldn't let it breathe, I couldn't let it be what it was. And one of my coaches at Troy was just like, you just gotta like let go. And for me, that was a game changer, as silly as it sounds and probably the millionth time it was told to me. But something just hit where I was just in a spot where I was holding on too tight. And then he was like, you just have to let go, like, you've done it. So the fifth and probably biggest lesson I learned, or the top takeaway, whatever you want to call it, is learning to advocate and use your voice. And advocating for yourself really became something new to me this last year as I am transitioning from college to the work life, which there isn't a very clear transition. And if you ask a lot of college people, they're like, oh, what do you want to do now that you're graduating? You don't have any closer idea than when you started college.
What's up, vlog? So senior year of college is done. That is so weird to say. Like, I've even been home for a week and a half now, and it's just so weird to be like, yeah, college, like, if Corona wasn't a thing, it's done. Like, those 4 years, it's gone, bye-bye. And I still haven't been able to, like, absorb that it's done. And, like, some of my closest people in Troy are graduating and left. Like, it's so weird to say. I don't know how to...
And for me,
I don't know what to think.
A big part of it was I always had the MO of actions speak louder than words. But then when you tie in the words aspect, it's like you can communicate through your actions that you can back up your words when you're talking to others. And learning that literally took me the whole time I was at school. And that's the biggest takeaway I have, because if you can't communicate with others and if you can't stand up for yourself, then you're just going to continue to kind of live in the background. And for some people that may be what you want, but when it comes to choosing how you want to live your life and what you want to do with it, it's better to come from you than from someone else. Those were my 5 takeaways. And leaving this vlog, it's crazy to even think about the 5 years went by so fast.
A joust and netball comes back to her and she says, okay, I got it this time.
And you can take it as far as you want it. If you don't like it, then you can leave it, but if you truly invest time into it, invest effort, and invest like a positive outlook on it, you'll get exactly what you signed up for. And I hope whoever is watching this, if they choose college volleyball, reach out. I want to hear your story about it. If they choose any college athletics, I want to hear what's changing. And I just wish you guys the best, and thank you for listening to my story about college athletics.